Hello everyone, I am Pratiksha and welcome back to Garden Minds. Today I will be talking about this stunning house plant, Diefenbachia, also known as Dumkin. Diefenbachia is very common and popular tropical indoor plant that is prized for its beautiful foliage and easy care requirements. Though they originate from the tropics, they make excellent house plants because they can easily adapt to growing indoors. Diefenbachia is also a great air purifying plant that reduces toxic elements from the indoor. Diefenbachia is a scientific name of the plant and Dumkin is a common name. Dumkin is really weird name of the plant, right? Well, there is a reason behind this name. The Dumkin got the name because there is a chemical in the sap, calcium oxalate, that can cause temporary loss of speech if any part of the plant is eaten. So if you have pets or kids at home, keep this plant out of reach and wash your hands after pruning. Many people get confused with aglaonema and Dumkin. Leaves of the Dumkin seem a bit wider when compared to the aglaonema's longer oval leaves. Plus the Dumkin stem has circle patterns on stem. There are lots of different species and cultivars out there these days and they are all gorgeous. Dumkins can live for many years and some varieties can grow to be several feet tall, creating very large flower plants. Some Dumkin varieties have dark green leaves with many white spotting. Variegated Dumkin is even more stunning and some have bright green or almost white leaves with dark edges. Just like any other living plant, Dumkin do require some care in order to grow their best. It is a tropical plant that grows well indoors with lots of indirect light. It can tolerate low light, but its growth will slow dramatically. Give more light, it will quickly begin to grow again. Keep this plant in a well-lit spot to perform its best. To keep its growth balanced on all sides, don't forget to rotate the plant periodically, otherwise its stem will bend towards the light. You can also keep this beautiful plant outdoor in partial shade, but don't keep this plant in direct sunlight. Direct sunlight can harm this beautiful foliage. This plant is belong to the family Araceae. It likes humidity and lots of water during the summer. You need to keep the soil slightly moist but not wet. It is important to maintain the humidity around this plant. Look at this beautiful plant and its lush foliage. Now in monsoon, this plant is growing effortlessly because now humidity is perfect for plant growth. In summer season, you can mist the leaves twice a week or you can keep this plant in a group to maintain the humidity. About soil mix, use fast draining, well aerated soil mix. Make sure drainage is good to avoid root rot. You can mix 30% garden soil, 30% compost and remaining perlite or riverside for best drainage. Instead of perlite, you can also use river sand, but don't use sea sand because it contains lots of salt. When you water the plant, water should drain out immediately, making the soil moist. For best result, you can repot Dumkin annually. Simply leave the plant as a whole, knock away any old or dry material from the roots and change the old soil and keep the plant in a new container. Watch out the signs of stress on the plant, such as roots poking out from the surface, sprouting or falling leaves, which could signal that the plant needs repotting. After repotting Dumkin, give it some time to adjust to its new setting. Make sure to wear gloves to avoid contact with the sap. As Dumkin grows, it tends to shed the lower leaves on the stem, which does not look good. To solve this problem, use sharp scissor to cut it back to the desired height and it will soon begin to sprout new leaves. And use the top shoot for propagation purpose. Just place the cutting in moist, well-turning soil. Do you know that the stem of dumkin root as well? Stem should have an eye from which new leaves or stem will emerge. Place about half the stem buried in the soil with the eye upward. Roots will start forming in about 2 to 4 weeks. Yellow wing of foliage is a common problem with dumkin, which is mostly related with watering schedule or nutrient deficiency. Underwatering or overwatering your plant can turn the leaves yellow. Often they will also fall off the plant. Check the soil by sticking a finger into the soil up to the first knuckle. If it's wet, hold off on watering for the week or so. You may have to go a little deeper to see if the soil is too dry, which means you need to add water to the plant. Leaves also could turn yellow because the plant is lacking nutrients such as nitrogen. Use nitrogen-rich fertilizer for the lush, huge leaves. You can mix handful of compost once in a 2 month or add any water-soluble fertilizer to the plant. That's all about this beautiful, stunning plant. I hope you find this video helpful. If you did, please hit the like button and subscribe to Garden Vibes. For more green updates, do follow us on Instagram. My Instagram handle is GardenVibes14. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Till then, take care and happy gardening.